I'll say what I am with him, John. We're gonna slit his throat.
You perk up with the orders.
You left us with nothing, John. We've got no ship.
You tell him, George.
It's okay. They've got you the only fresh water
we
on
come
the island.
Money, John, that was owed. And your captaincy ain't got us a single coin.
The boy is currency. Why can't you see that?
The boy is awake.
Jim? Where's the captain? Where's the doctor? Have you killed them?
What if we have?
Well, we haven't. Because seeing the ship gone, that doctor traded off our stores for this stream here. Now they've gone where they've gone. But their parting words were that they were sick of you, Jim. Sick of you and your turncoat wanderings. So now it seems you're back in my camp. Or none at all.
I won't join you, Silver. Not now, nor any day, never.
Slit him!
No! I am your captain, and I am sick of this killing.
You're still clinging to captaincy, John. I'm calling a crew's conference. Outside, boys!
Don't go out there, Tom. Tom!
I've lost them, Jim. Since the ship's gone, there's been a swell of anarchy. And you're half a blank away from death, boy.
I ain't afraid to die now, John.
Well, bully for you. But you die here, and that mother of yours is all alone in the world. You take it as her.
Jimmy. We gotta help each other a bit. Cause you and me is all we got now. George Murray's gonna come for me. It's in the air. But I got insurance in my pocket. If you've got an ace in your collar, now's the time to reveal it, boy. Cause God help me, I don't wanna see you die. God bless me for that. Give me something so I can help you.
I have the ship. It's beached up in the north. It's safe.
The ship?
Hans and Anderson are dead. I've done some of that killing myself.
Well, we won't mention who killed their mates. But the ship is good.
Good insurance.
Come outside, John Silver, and bring the boy.
I said you were smart.
Step up, then.
What you got? It's the black spot, Jimmy.
We took a vote. And it's on account of your bungling, Silver. And your best friend, Patience.
Says deposed on the back.
We listen to you. Now we've got no treasure, no man.
And we got no boys. Could you lead them right to the guns?
You were never man enough to be our captain, John.
So is it not man enough to say that me and the boy have got the ship safe?
Where?
The boy knows, and he ain't told me. But says for payment, he'll lead us there. And that's the way it's gonna stay.
You're lying.
And is it not man enough to say that when that fierce doctor came to negotiate passage this morning, that I got, through a captain's guile, possession of Flint's map?
The doctor gave you the map?
Prove it.
Touch.
That's it. That's Flint's hand. George, that's Flint's hand.
Why'd you keep this from us?
What was the point without a ship? But now I can surprise my loyal boys and say, let's go and make ourselves rich.
Yeah, let's go now.
Shall we just throw this away then, lads?
Yeah. Yeah.
Ha ha ha.
Tom?
Tom. Get up, lad. Get up, son. Gotta think about what this treasure's gonna bring us.
Fine wines. Arabian silver.
John, please. Tell me more, John.
Turkish delay. Houses as big as fields. Carriages. For you and all your ladies, Tom.
It's all white in here. John. John.
John.
It says a pointer.
It'll be up, John, up.
What do you see?
John?
What is it?
Recognize that cap, boys. That's Allardyce.
That's our captain's pointer.
What was that, John?
How far is it, Silver?
It's definitely Flint, that is.
It's all right, John.
What's that? What's that you say?
It's Captain Flint.
Is that you, Captain?
It's not Flint's voice.
What was it then?
That's his song.
I know that voice. That's a Yankee voice. That's Ben Gunn. Ben Gunn, that you out there?
That's Ben Gunn.
How can you be scared about him, boys? He was a runt when he sailed with us, and he's a runt now. I know your Yankee voice, Ben Gunn!
And the devil is done the
Did you kill him?
Didn't I? I did, yes.
It's only 100 yards now, lads. 100 yards from the pointer, and then 12 paces from the ceiba tree.
Come on, let's go there!
All right, hold on for your captain, lads.
There's
hold
the tree!
On.
That tree! That tree!
Wait! Wait for your captain!
Oh, no. This ain't good, Jim. Stand by for trouble, boy. Stay close to your John.
Two guineas. I think 300,000, John. Two guineas. Huh?
Boom!
Ah, you're the man for the bargaining, are you? With your captain's guile.
This cripple has led us to nothing, boys. It's two guineas worth a life's worth.
Stand behind me, Jim. This is our boy.
Keep your guns on him, boys. I'm gonna hang this mongrel from a tree.
Be safe, Jim.
Yes, sir. See, you've been excavating before us, Dr. Livesey.
Not me.
It took 2.5 years to find the spot, like all over the island.
Young Mr. Gunn.
Shall I kill the devil, Captain Dave? Kill all devils on the island, all that other slant in their eyes?
No, Ben. Don't. Did someone tell me where my treasure is?
Captain Dave's treasure it is. Maybe Jim's. Maybe his there, whose name I forgot. Don't know what it's called.
Bargained away the treasure for a cake of cheese and Trelawney's Bible, didn't you, Ben?
It's like a slice of heaven, Mr. Silver. It's everything you want. Is it? This is my house, Christian Jean. Captain Smollett.
Safe, Jim. It's good to see you, young man.
What's he doing?
Between him and Jim, the others are dead.
Me and Jim, sir. I looked out for him, I did.
You're a mutineer, Silver.
Are you doing the adding up, Squire Trelawney? A little bit of bookwork.
You're a mutineer. And you will be hanged as one when we get home.
I think the lad would talk of a different John Silver. One who was forced to mutiny and a crew he tried to control.
You've seen what kind of a man you are, Silver.
Silver came between me and a knife and Captain. He risked his neck on my behalf.
I hope everyone's listening to this, honest young man.
Get that man in irons, Litty.
No, let's try and have some better thoughts, shall we? Ones that befit gentlemen. Now, you did a deal with a professor of divinity over there. Something about cheese and a Bible. So you could do a deal with me.
There'll be no deal with you.
I'm the only one left alive who owns this gold, who earned this gold. And ownership is 9/10 of the law.
Possession is 9/10 of the law.
Well, that's a different law, not one I like.
I don't care what you like. I don't care about the law. You're a thief and a murderer. You've brought peril and destruction to this whole enterprise. All this mirror here, and these sacks, this chest, all these coins. They're now legally mine, my possession and my ownership, because I have taken them through my venture and risk.
Trelawney, the risk you took was with other men's lives.
I was talking of a risk financial.
Which does not exist separate to men's lives. However you try to insulate the thought that it might. This is contraband, sir, stained thick with blood. And when we get back to England, if we manage to get off this island, it will be handed over as such.
Aye, aye. I have the ship, sir. Beached up on the north coast.
There is another way to end this, Captain Smollett, which is perhaps more palatable to the futures of all present, which is we share a little what's won amongst all us loyal survivors. And we share it, each according to his station. And you being the captain, sir. You being the captain.
Put Mr. Silver in irons, Dr. Livesey. He will be tried for mutiny. In Bristol. Sir.
Captain.
Been watching you, John. Watching this last dance all the way.
I know that.
And I'll be the last thing you see when you do your little jig at execution dock.
I was loyal to you. 15 years, my captain.
Loyalty. Loyalty, John. Is what you can hold in your hand.
Thinking, Christian Jim. Thinking of my home and what's there for me. This is my home.
You're coming with us, Ben.
And now that the treasure's gone, no devils will come and hurt me here. Take my heaven. That's what Ben Gunn thinks. That's what he'll do.
What are you doing?
Protecting you. From the world out there.
You'll do all right in the world, Ben.
Seen them blistered and starved in the boats of that gold. There's no heaven out there.
It's the right way, Hawkins.
Keep going, sir.
The nets is ballast to the quarter deck, Jim. I'm gonna need much weight on the stern to help lift her off. Dr. Livesey, Mr. Gray.
Sure.
It's that cannon from the bow.
Aye, Captain.
Tide will do the rest.
Let's go now.
doing? Hey! Stop that! Stop that! What are you doing?
Any more of that and I'll snap your neck!
It's all going!
Swirling, stop him!
Let him do it.
There's two more bags to go, Jim.
Secure Mr. Silver below deck, Mr. Gray.
Aye, sir.
Let's get to Jamaica, crew up, and go home.
Flying her colors off Boss Castle. Jim's coming home.
This is wonderful, Jim. Suitable feast for our last night.
On arrival in Bristol, Mr. Gray, I need the assistance of the Sergeant at Arms. We need to take Silver into custody. Are you still planning on speaking up for him, Jim?
I am, sir. I will too. I chose to stand between Jim and death on two occasions.
It won't save him, Jim. He's one of Flint's men. And he'll drop for that alone.
Yeah, those potatoes like I told you.
I did.
Plenty of butter. That's the thing. Pad your sails out for the chilly winters. It's fit enough for the captain's table, is it? They made a sea cook out of you. When do we dock?
Tomorrow morning.
Aye, sir.
Something you can do for me, lad. The woman you met down the Spyglass. My wife. I don't want to come into the trial and see me played out. Will you see to that? Give her this. Take a bit for your mum. But my girl gets a lion's share, all right?
Where do you get that?
I'm a bloody thief, Jim. They gave me a load of treasure and told me to drag it through the jungle. Me and the parrot have been thinking. We don't want a lab with prospects getting tainted by speaking up for one of Flint's crew. So you don't do it. All right? I don't want it. I'll make a fine gentleman, Jim Hawkins. Now, look at this mashed potato, all mashed to high heaven. Fine enough to grace any captain's table. You can go now.
North Devon coast.
Jimmy, if you ever want help or advice,
I won't be coming to you.
Yeah, it's probably best. But if you ever want to venture, want to feel that spirit inside, come looking for Long John. You'll be waiting.
I will.
And keep Flint for me, for safekeeping.
Go on, go on.
I'll come for him Monday. Remember, Jim. Any of us living, come looking. I'll be there, I will, my gentleman. As a fine gentleman.